Tomorrow night, BBC Two will screen Akira, a groundbreaking animated science fiction movie from Japan. It's the most celebrated example yet of what the Japanese call anime, the visually astonishing, imaginative, bizarre, and sometimes deliriously violent epics that spring from the huge comic culture in that country.
Visual effects are amazing.
It's totally different.
Lots of tentacles.
It makes anything that's come out from any other company look like one of these late night Czechoslovakian kind of cartoons.
Here, they are commonly known as manga, the Japanese word for the comics on which they are based. Manga literally means irresponsible pictures. And believe me, some of these pictures are irresponsible. They're currently the hottest thing on video. In the UK alone, Akira has shifted over 70,000 copies to date. The films are loved by the fans and reviled by their critics. Like Star Trek and Doctor Who, the fan network is a highly organized group of dedicated individuals who hold regular conventions around the country, like this one in Birmingham.
This is the fifth British anime convention, devoted exclusively to Japanese animation. It's been run by fans, for fans. It's a totally non-profit event. And essentially, it's just people who already know a bit about anime and love it, or have heard about it and want to find out more about it, coming together to watch screenings of shows, see some lovely artwork done by the attendees, buy merchandise and have a good time.
Began back in 1987 when I saw Robotech, and a friend of mine showed it to me. I thought, wow, you know, why isn't Scooby-Doo like this?
Fresh look, fresh design, fresh storytelling aspects, good animation.
Come back here, you thief! You can't get away with this! Give me that!
Let's go!
A much more dynamic animation. And when I say dynamic, that can be in action terms, but also in characterization terms. A confrontation between two people, say having a lover's tiff, would be very, very well directed and certainly up to the standard of a live action program.
If a character's walking in an American or British design, they might only do like three or four steps, but the Japanese actually draw every in-between step. And if you see someone racing down the street, you actually see the speed lines. They actually take the time to show shadows of characters and face details.
Well, in Japan, you know, there's a vast paraphernalia of books, key rings, fluffy toys, model kits, of all sorts, from mass-produced kits to what they call garage kits, which are small-run kits produced very often by fans in strange esoteric materials like soft vinyl and resin. My first exposure to it was seeing a lot of the translated TV series in the 60s, things like Marine Boy.
I'll have to stay under for a long time, so I'll need this oxygum.
Back then, when I was a child, I didn't know that these things originated in Japan and probably didn't care, but my partner, Helen McCarthy, started a little fanzine, just a photocopied newsletter, to try and sort of rally people together who were interested in this thing, because we knew if we liked it, there must be loads of other people if they could just get in touch with each other.
My youngest reader that I know of is 12 years old. My oldest reader, as far as I know, is 58. And in age terms, I suppose the core bracket is sort of 17 to 25.
The chance to see the latest manga release uncut at a special sneak preview brought fans from all over the country to a private Halloween party in London's West End.
People have seen them on sale in the shops and the colours sort of leap out at you.
One of my friends brought this film along and we all sat around my house, watched it, and I'm just addicted now, and I told them. And
she addicted me, definitely.
What a fool! Do you think that you have a chance against someone of my lineage?
The dialogue leaves a fair amount to be desired.
But who the devil are you that you can simply fling away the sword of the mightiest general of the Pelsian army? Eh? Huh?
It's better executed.
I think it's down to design, other than Japanese design.
It's all good stuff. It's fast moving and, you know, technical. It goes down well.
So who exactly is buying this stuff and where do they get it from?
In Britain, there are less female fans than I personally would like to see. We have a lot of female readers, but it's probably split about 20% female, 80% male at the moment as far as fandom goes. It's predominantly because the marketing has been aimed very squarely at that bracket. The style in which it's marketed, the magazines in which it's marketed, the way it's racked in shops, computer game shops particularly, rack it extensively.
It's the Colonel!
Japan is world famous for its super strict education and obedient pupils. But what happens out of school? Is manga the only way to rebel for Japanese youth? Here they are at play on a Sunday afternoon in a Tokyo park.
戦後の日本貧しい時期に日本人のエンターテインメントっていうものはやはりお金とか人のいる映画はできなかったんだけれど、そういう時にそれに代わる夢とか希望とかというものを漫画で楽しんだ。文化がそのだんだん若くなったんですよね。昔はもう少し年寄りの文化だったんですけどね、ちょうど文化が若くなりだした頃に漫画が流行りだしたんじゃないですかね。一番盛んになり始めて、それから60年代の半ばぐらいからだと思うんですけどね。それまで子供たちに支持されていても、それほどの市民権を手に入れたもんじゃなかったです。で、その60年代の半ば過ぎから青年たちも読み始めるようになった。それからその青年たちが父親になり、中年になったのに未だに漫画を読んでるというふうな現象が起こったんですね。
Tokyo's giant population means that millions travel on the subway every day. What better way to ease the pain of the rush hour than with your favourite manga?
あの、漫画の流行というのが、そのストレスを、社会の激変のストレスをね、緩和する材料に使われたんじゃないかなっていう気がしてます。 先祖を訪ねれば、その中世の時代に今の漫画の先祖と言えるようなものがあるんですね。それは楽しみのためのというものよりも宗教的な意味とかいろいろな理由で書かれたものですけども、今日見ても これが自分たちの先祖だなと思うようなものがここにありますけど、そういうそのこう絵巻物と私たち呼んでますけどね。
In these medieval picture scrolls, the artist portrayed not only everyday life, but also lurid and detailed visions of hell and damnation. Producing millions of comics requires a huge industry and state-of-the-art technology. This plant uses robot labor to do all but the most specialized tasks. But being Japanese, these are no ordinary robots. Each one has its own theme tune. Kodansha is one of the biggest publishers in Japan. They have hundreds of titles, including some of the best-selling manga. Some are the size of telephone directories, with titles like Young Magazine and Comic Morning. Their editors are constantly trying out artists in the quest for new talent to fill those thousands of pages. Manga readers of all ages flock to the bookstores for the latest, eagerly awaited installment of their favorite stories. The vast majority of strips in these manga are drawn by homegrown artists, and until recently, they were read only by the Japanese. But now some stories are being translated and published here in the UK. By way of an exchange, British artists have also been commissioned by Kodansha.
Dominator, Violator, Extricator, Decimator come from a region of hell called Darkadia. When I showed them the designs, they pointed out specifically what they liked. And they said, well, can you develop this into an ongoing series in color? They have new artists coming up who they showcase in this magazine, Comic Afternoon. It is cutting edge stuff in that sense. There's a lot more room in Japan to try out different ideas. And the editors and the publishers really encourage different styles, writing styles, art styles. I mean, they really go for it. I mean, they're very much geared up towards developing something.
Buichi Terasawa is one of the most successful manga artists working. His strange heavy metal fantasies have also been made into animation.
そうすると日本で1億人いて、それが一人の作家が1000万部出す時代に、今でも紙が足りないというのにね、でそれを CD-ROM に置き換えたいと。
Using a specially designed Macintosh computer, Terasawa is able to produce images of startling quality. Most people will read this work in book form, but he sees other, more revolutionary applications in the not too distant future.
データへのデータも永久保存が効くわけだし、でそれをまたアニメーションの方にデータとして使うこともできる。日本の漫画の主題になってるのは、年を追ってどんどん非常に平凡な話っていうのが多くなってきて、日常的な宇宙に出てて冒険をするとかね、そういうものをテーマにして変えていきたいと思ってます。
Terasawa's latest animation features a lone samurai battling a crazed witch with an army of mechanical helpers.
ですから、その漫画を元にして、アニメーション。紙で描いたものを動かしたいというのがアニメーションということでできたと思うんですけれど、今度そのアニメーションを一方的にこう受け取るだけじゃなくて、自分が主人公になってその中に参加していきたいということで、それをコンピューターゲームにしていこうというような発想が生まれたと思うんですね。
The Japanese fetish for games and gadgets of all kinds is on full display in a part of Tokyo called Akihabara, known as the Electronic City. part of Tokyo by Night could easily be mistaken for the set of Blade Runner. The influence of that film and other cyberpunk masterworks like The Terminator and Aliens can be seen in the work of Katsuhiro Otomo, director of Akira. Akira began life in the 80s as a comic book, and then in 1987, Otomo began work on the animated feature.
Tokyo に出てきた時のそういういろんな面白い人間がいっぱいいたんでね。やっぱ未来の東京を描いてみようかなと。で、それを今まで僕がその、例えば学生運動があったりとかね、その暴走族がいたりとか、政治運動があったりヤクザがいたりその不良少年たちがいたりっていう今まで見てきたそういう東京だったり日本の自分の周りの世界だったりするものを、その SF の東京の未来の東京に入れたということですか。
警備に当たっていた機動隊と学生の間で小競り合いが起きており、怪我人が出た模様です。
若い時にその映画を見ながらいろいろ、まあ、自分で勉強したんですけれども、例えば漫画にしてもアニメーションにしても、まあ、アニメーションは映画に近いですからね、どういうふうにしてその、自分の表現したいものをこう形にするかっていうテクニックみたいなところはね、勉強しましたけどね。その見せ方であるとかスピード感であるとかそういうなんとか、まあ、カッティングであるとかね編集とか。
あれだ！
海
キ
ーあれだ！
金田くん
乗れ
乗れってどこに
早く早く
みんなと友達と酒を飲んでる時にねいろんな面白いアイデアが出るんですけどねそれが全部その時は面白くてもね酒が冷めるとね面白くないですからね僕はそれでもう少し半年か1年ぐらいって感じですかね。そうですね、それからそういうキャラクターを作ったりね どういうこういうシーンではこういう絵がいいだろうなみたいな風にしてだんだん少しずつこう形にしていくということです。
For his latest film, Otomo is using both traditional cell painting techniques and computer animation, a combination he first used in Akira.Akira was produced at one of Japan's most prolific studios, Tokyo Movie Shinsha. Here they turn out hundreds of hours of animation every year for TV and cinema. The range of subjects is huge and sometimes bewildering to say the least. Sport, westerns, samurai and giant robots rub shoulders with Cuddly Pandas and Enid Blyton, not forgetting the intriguingly titled Hello Spank. And how about a flying whale doing battle with Atlantis? There is one man currently working who is surprisingly little known outside Japan. His name is Hayao Miyazaki, and he made the most successful film at the box office in Japan last year, Porco Rosso, The Crimson Pig.
Miyazaki is often referred to as the Disney of Japan. There is nothing in a Miyazaki film that you would be worried about your grandmother or your five-year-old daughter seeing. That sounds derogatory, and it isn't. He is a magical, lyrical filmmaker, an inspirational filmmaker, and I have huge respect for him. For example, in My Neighbor Totoro, the person he was aiming his film at when he made it was the young urban Japanese who has never experienced the magic of a country childhood because they've grown up in Tokyo, the metropolis, which has grown so vastly since the 50s and 60s. He creates a wonderful fantasy about Totoro, the elemental spirit of the woodlands.
より普遍的な、つまり日本の国内だけではなくて、世界の人たちが見ても理解されるものを作る普遍的な表現力を持つためには、そのアニメーションが映画にならなきゃいけません。ということが今、具体的に問われている時期に差し掛かっている。その中で私たちはフィルムを作るわけですから、その今までの同じ考え方でフィルムは作れない部分がいっぱいあります。
あ、目、目。
それについて自分たちが果たして回答を出せるのか、回答は出せなくても一緒にとにかく生きていこうという提案をすることができるぐらいならできるのかとか、そういう話をよくします。
遅かった。
女の子と金貨をさらわれた。取り戻してくれ。あっちに逃げた。
Which leaves us with the two big questions. Why have the press been up in arms about Manga, and why do those characters have such big eyes?
The girls have big eyes and they've got the small noses. It's very typical.
I think that's the thing that most people latch on to, the big eyes, although there are a whole series of little visual languages really to be sort of picked up. It's almost like learning Japanese as a language, except you're talking about a visual language. For instance, the proportions of the figure are much longer or elongated, and there are certain ways of drawing shading and things like that. The big guy thing goes back to the father of the animation and manga industry, Osamu Tezuka. He was very influenced in his early years by both Disney and the Fleischer brothers, and seized on at that look because of the old sort of, you know, thing that the eyes are the mirror of the soul, and that sort of great innocence of character. It is interesting because when you start looking into the programs, you realize that, you know, that they've got Japanese names and yet they look incredibly Western. In fact, there are a few instances of characters, you know, who are drawn in an Oriental way. And interesting enough, quite often they're the baddies.
How come that the ultimate deterrent didn't get him? And if he escaped, how did he get to the hospital so fast?
How should I know? Listen, you guys, sneak in the side entrance and get the urine, and I'll take care of that tank.
Over here, cat girl.
日本の漫画とかアニメーションは今、等身大、要するに、見る人が自分たちの生活の中で感じられるようなスタイルなので、男の子から見てこういう女の子がいいなっていうような、とてもおしゃれで、スタイルも良くて胸も大きくて、すぐにデートに誘えるような。
So you want to play hard to get, do you? You know you're even prettier when you're angry, so in spite of what you said, I'm still...
But a lot of the very popular series, there's Ranma and Lum and Bubblegum Crisis, they've all got female heroes.
Now you want to play rough, huh?
I think any complaints that are made are probably because of the English attitude towards women that already exist.
I think that to the Japanese, and this is only my opinion, law is the result of society cooperating together. And so while you will get young people in Japan watching material which would shock their parents, you won't get anyone in Japan supposing that this is a reason why violence on the streets occurs.
Japanese have got this thing about ordered cities, and they like to see loads of destruction, you know, in their everyday lives. It's very, very structured, very rigid.
I like the violence. It's what drew me towards it and made me want to go out and buy some more.
You can do whatever you want with animation. You're limited with human bodies.
Makes it more realistic, I think.
It's more realistic. It's not all hearts and flowers and little dicky birds tweeting in the sky.
People choose to see them. They are videos. People buy them, you know. So what's the problem?
We do in this country have a fairly reliable system of film censorship. Given that that happens, I feel it's unreasonable of the newspapers to blame filmmakers and film distributors when material falls into inappropriate hands. I agree this is deplorable, but I don't think it's an argument to stop the release of 18 certificate videos. I think it's an argument to improve parenting and retailing.
日本を理解したいと漫画を通じて日本を理解したい方だったら暴力とセックスに満ちた漫画だけでなく優れた漫画を見てもらいたい日本を理解するためにはねでもそうでない場合はその商売としてそのショッキングなそのフィルムやその印刷をその紹介してお金にしようと思っている人たちがいるわけですから
もちろんそういうセックスシーンがいっぱい出てくるのもバイオレンスないやつもあるんだけども逆にそうでないものもいっぱいあるっていうことを分かってもらいたい
実はテレビというものが生活の中にどれほど入り込んできてしまったかそれが一番大きな問題なんですそれでもしテレビがその日常生活の中のある限られたこう特定の時間に収まっていればその中でアニメーションをやっても悪い影響は全然出ないと思いますでも放らずに好き勝手に四六時中ものを考えずに、そのポテトチップスを食べながらテレビを見ていたら、それはどんなものを見ても悪影響があるでしょう。
So, careful what you watch. We've only showed you a fraction of the anime that exists. A lot of it's not available here, but there are several new video labels in development and new films in production all the time. Before I go, here's another taste of what's in store in Akira tomorrow night. Sayonara.